hanging out here at Fort Wilderness, just had lunch at Trails End, and on our way back to the boat, there was an armadillo, which is a funny looking little animal. Oops, scared him. Anyway, just got done with lunch. Really, pretty nice. What do you think?
Delish. I am stuffed.
Reviews? Matt?
Good buffet.
It's a limited buffet, not a whole lot of items. What they did have was good, though. Fried chicken was good. They had,
Cornbread
was good. Barbecue beef was good. I thought it was a little expensive. It was $17. Not sure if it's worth the price or not. I mean, you are paying Disney prices, but still, I thought that was a little steep for what they were offering. But decent. Nice beach here at the Fort Wilderness, too. We better hurry up and make that boat.
Yeah, we'd be fine.
Really great views from around here, though.
We're not even heading in that direction.
You could rent watercraft if you wanted to.
No, that was not a raindrop.
Something just hit me, and it felt like a raindrop.
You're drunk.
I am not.
Well, do you think that was a raindrop? Like,
no.
Something wet just hit me.
Look at the sky.
Crystal clear.
All right, for those of us that aren't drunk, some of you didn't. Oh, I just walked into this thing. Oh, that hurt.
All right. Been drinking too.
Anyway, that's the old Discovery Island, the old
Last
zoo that used to be there.
Last time I
get my
discount for
you. Ow, my feet hurt. That was painful. Hurry up and get on this boat. Who?
Oh, wait.
We're on the wrong side.
Oh my god.
Whoops. All right, I'm going to hop on this boat and get back to the Magic Kingdom. And here we have giant Rice Krispie treats. They're like the size of a plate. She's counting them now.
They're huge.
What are they, Matt?
They're huge.
They are. And you could buy them over here. How much are these giant Rice Krispie treats?
An arm and a leg.
They're actually really heavy. How much do they cost? $12.95. That's not terrible. For a Rice Krispie treat that feeds like 7 people.
And they're Christmas themed balls.
Christmas balls.
For $6.95.
Wow. 8 balls for $6.95. That's quite the deal. What's up, everybody? We are in the Fast Pass line at the new Space Mountain. And I'm going to go past all. It was like a 50-minute wait. As much as I would love to show you the interactive games, is how much I don't want to wait 50 minutes in line.
Scoot it.
So we got Fast Passes early this morning. Space Mountain, always one of my favorite attractions here at Magic Kingdom. And I thought it was a good refurb, not a great refurb, as I said on In Loop, probably. You do listen on Mondays. Good job. I'm happy they did it. Is it worth the 7-month closure? In my opinion, no. But some of the stuff is neat. Here you see one of the interactive games. And it's too dark to see the buttons over there, but there are buttons. Maybe I'll get a better shot out here. You can see you stop for a minute and play the games. Definitely a neat idea. There are tons of game screens, as you can see walking by. Some of the bigger ones, some of the smaller ones are like little plasma screens or something like that. And you play simple games with like asteroids and that kind of thing. Over here on the right, you have some of the traditional Pippers Ghost kind of hologrammy effects. But it definitely makes it, if you're waiting in this very long queue, it makes it much more manageable now that it's got a simple little interactive game. Here we are in the futuristic new load station for Space Mountain. Probably the best part of the refurb here. The like new planets and stuff on the ceiling. They did a good job. We got air gates now. It zooms in. Definitely looks cooler than it did before. Neat. I'm gonna get ready to ride one of my favorite rides here at the Magic Kingdom. And here we are on Space Mountain. There's Matt. I'm looking kind of bored. Cassie, of course, is drunk. Now we're gonna go walk through the new post show area.
What martini should I order tonight?
Exit to Tomorrowland is to your right, and to your left is doors that aren't normally open.
For our safety, please do not sit on
moving. Alright, Disney geeks. The Mesa Verde bumper sticker. What makes it important? Huh? Disney geeks?
On the moving handrail.
Nothing? I know a bunch of you at home know this. Reference to the old Horizons ride over at Epcot. I believe it was the desert planet you could go to was named Mesa Verde. but I'm not sure. I think so. Post show's been updated, really cool, and
that was for the ladder.
Mm-hmm. It's definitely updated from the old Future of Shipping FedEx ad that was at the end. And then we got one more show scene over here with a robot butler. It's the only drinks at the Magic Kingdom.
Right there.
And that's neat. Since I love merchandise at Walt Disney, I want to show off the new Space Mountain t-shirt. Personally have a copy of this one. It looks fantastic on me. It's really the only piece of merchandise that has Space Mountain on it, which I thought weird. Yeah, I mean, the Space Mountain gift shop here sells mostly Mickey Mouse stuff, candy, and Vinylmation. But they do have this really cool Mickey Mouse turntable t-shirt. Isn't that neat? The rare Scrooge McDuck meet and greet. You never get to see Scrooge McDuck. That's so cool.
Hey, where are you? Hey! Tinkerbell!
Am I supposed to look like a moron? Like, oh, okay.
Oh, look! Tinkerbell!
Did you get that? That was awesome.
Now we just got off Pirates of the Caribbean and we're playing with toy guns. They're like the coolest toy guns ever.
Oh, yeah.
You cock them, and when mine's already cocked, it lights up. But then when you pull the trigger, it's like a flashlight. How cool is that? It makes noise. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, I'm with her. All right, gang, we reached the end of the video. We're gonna hang out over here by Splash Mountain. See, what I did before we started filming today, I went onto the Coaster Crew Facebook page. Matt, where can you find that?
At facebook.com/coastercrew.
Yes.
Spelled wrong.
Fearless leader Clint Novak and his spelling ability misspelled the name of the website, and you can't change it. So if you're not friends with Coaster Crew yet, go to facebook.com/coastercrew, COO, in his infinite wisdom. Now we're going to hang out here because what I did before the thing, I got to put it up on there. Hey, I'm going to Magic Kingdom. What do you guys want to see? Our buddy Kane wanted to see some Splash Mountain action. So here is some Splash Mountain action.
There you go, buddy.
That guy's enjoying his Splash Mountain action. That's about it. Nice day at Magic Kingdom. Matt did not get to meet his favorite character, Terrence the Male Fairy. We were going to go, but...
Nope, never will, I don't think.
45-minute wait. Cassie had fun because her eyes are bloodshot and she doesn't know what's going on.
Legend, I'm gonna kill you.
Right, now, a fun day. Now the usual stuff. Go on the Coaster Crew forums and post. Not like him, not like her, who both have usernames and don't post, and everyone else that doesn't post. It's pretty much a conversation.
Oh, stop posting!
It's like a conversation between me and Monster Fan. What up, Monster Fan? I know you're watching. And that's pretty much it. Watch, listen in the loop every Monday night at 8 or on iTunes. And of course, Matt. You know what Matt wants to plug.
Yeah. It's twitter.com/MattGrass.
Drunk, you have nothing to plug, do you?
If you guys like me, friend me.
Great. That's Cassie the Drunk at Facebook.com.
Shut up, I'm not the drunk.
All right, anyway, catch you out. Check us out Monday nights at 8.
Yeah.